I'm Kashmira Devil, LILA Girl 2012, LILA Fellow 2015, and Peace Ambassador 2017. I would like to introduce you to a very special person today. Our guest of honor for today's program is Aparna Dharma, Didi, and a LILA Fellow 1999. I'm saying it Didi because she is our own LILA sister. With 20 years of experience in the IT industry, she has worked with industries, companies like P&O, Ned Lloyd, and John Deere, and also made a mark as a leader. She has handled multiple leadership positions in the IT process excellence, compliance, and information security. She has been instrumental in leading key projects in implementing international standards like ISO, CMMI, and security and privacy frameworks like HITRUST, GDPR, etc. during her tenure. Post her master's, Aparna completed 20 certifications related to IT process frameworks and various standards, which fully equipped her of the role and made her stay abreast with the latest technological developments in this field. Apart from taking an active part in the initiatives of the foundation, her biography is a part of the book 21st Century Belongs to Them, published by LILA Poonawalla Foundation. This book, 21st Century Belongs to Them, has 23 short stories of LILA fellows who, with their grit and determination and with the support of foundation, have made great progress towards achieving their goals. The idea of the book was inspired by our late president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir, which he shared with LILA Mom. Aparna, along with other LILA fellows, had the privilege and honor to meet Kalam sir at Rashtrapati Bhavan, Delhi, where he discussed with the young fellows about their dreams of the future. She has also served as an LPF panel member for interviews and selection of young girls, deserving girls for scholarships. Coming from a humble background, which gave utmost priority to values, education, and principles, Aparna excelled in academics along with pursuing sports and painting as her hobbies. Her family encouraged independence and self-reliance, thus making her financially independent at a very young age. She is an emerging artist and has showcased her paintings on the India Art Gallery platform. She was also crowned at Miss Pune Beautiful Hair in the year 2003. She gives complete credit of her success to her parents, our LILA Poonawalla Foundation family, her mentors, her family of mother-in-law, her husband, and a daughter who are her strongest supports today. Now, without further ado, I would like to kindly come on the dais and share her thoughts with us.
Thank you, Kashmira, for the wonderful introduction. Namaskar, Mandali. I'm truly humbled and honored to be with all of you today at this prestigious and unique award ceremony. A very warm good evening to our chief guest, Mr. Valen, Mom, Dad, and all the dignitaries on the dais, proud recipients of the LILA Poonawalla Foundation Scholarship, my dear parents, and all my friends. For someone like me, this is a dream come true. 20 years back, on the same platform, I had received this prestigious scholarship and was warmly welcomed into the LILA Poonawalla Foundation family. Irrespective of the accolades and the titles mentioned in my introduction, today I stand before you as the same LILA Fellow of 99 and as the daughter of LILA Mom and Dad. Foundation has been a world within itself. Apart from giving me lovely parents as LILA Mom and Dad, it has given also me amazing mentors in the form of our trustees. It also gave me the opportunity to connect with many wonderful girls who had varied dreams and aspirations, but were tied with the same thread of the foundation. We had many activities and events which involved a lot of learning, along with meeting experts from the industry. I remember looking up at all of them with lot of amazement, awe, and respect, and always wondered, how do these people become so successful in their life? This curiosity fueled me and inspired me to do better and become the best in my work. I always strived to become a better version of myself. It never let me sit down quietly. It never allowed me to become complacent. And it never let me settle for less. You know why? Because now the foundation was watching me. Today also when I take a decision, I think, what will LILA Mom and dad say, what will they tell me to do? Is this in line with what they taught us? Receiving the foundation scholarship is a privilege. Being part of the foundation is a responsibility. And fulfilling their dreams is an honor which very chosen few like us are privy to. One of the most memorable events of my life is the honor and privilege of meeting our late president, Dr. Abdul Kalam at Rashtrapati Bhavan, along with Kiran Bedi ma'am. Being part of the book, 21st Century Belongs to Them, itself made us feel on top of the world. And meeting Dr. Kalam was absolutely out of this world experience. It was a rare gift which the foundation bestowed upon 23 girls, of which and because of which I will be eternally grateful to the foundation. Since 99, in some way or the other, I have tried to be in touch with this great family of mine through participation in activities, events, conducting interviews, and selecting eligible girls for this scholarship. Throughout all my experiences, one learning was always common. The bar of excellence that LILA mom had set for the foundation and for all of us. She never compromised on anything. She never missed a single detail and always made us question our decision and our choices. And hence, she has been a loving, caring mother and an equally tough and a disciplining mom. And we know that stems out of her passion and her love for the foundation and for all of us. Various situations came in, various ups and downs came in my life, and they taught me huge lessons. And I'm taking this opportunity to share few key learnings which have become a mantra for me to take decisions in my life. The first and foremost being relationships. This is one of the most crucial aspects of a life, and it starts with your relationship with yourself. I came across a very thoughtful quote, and it goes like this. Be careful with your words, because you are listening. The quality of your relationship with others is going to depend a lot on the relationship you have with yourself. If you take care of yourself, maintain good emotional stability, if you respond rather than react, and nourish yourself with good thoughts, that's going to reflect in your relationship with others. Whenever we succeed, people clap for us, but actually the applaud is for the entire support system that got you to that place at that moment. Each person, be it your family, friend, foundation, mentors, peers at work, people in your college, even your domestic head, each person has played a great role in getting you to this place today. And hence, being thankful towards them and being grateful towards them is our first job. The second and the most important thing that I give priority to is continuous learning. Everything you learn comes to your help or rescue one day or the other. Steve Jobs always mentioned how a simple calligraphy class in his college was the deciding factor for a beautiful Mac typography. And he always gives credit to each point, each area that he learned. So never stop learning. Seize every opportunity to further your knowledge and understanding about things. Seek clarity. Go beyond. Ask the question why, then the what and the how will be clear. LILA Punala Foundation provides you the most competent platform to stay abreast with new and emerging trends. You are given the opportunity to meet industry experts and senior LILA fellows who, with their experiences, can guide you towards a better career. Overall development of the girls has been a key focus of the foundation, and the success of these programs depend only on one thing. Can you tell me? Your participation. That's it. The success of these programs is going to depend only on your participation. So girls, my humble request, please participate in all the amazing programs and just embrace all these new learnings. You will get to meet top industry experts. We already have most of them on the dais. And learning from LILA mom and Firoz dad and their experiences is a unique experience in itself. The third and the most important thing for me is what I think, my thoughts. This is a bit deeper one. And I believe that my thoughts are going to create my belief systems, which are going to lead to my habits and actions. Thus, Lord Buddha also says, what you think, you become. What you feel, you attract. And what you imagine, you create. Thank you, friends, for listening to me so patiently. I'm eternally grateful to my parents, Leela mom and dad, my loving family, all of whom have been great contributors in making my life a beautiful one. I would like to end my address by quoting Steve Jobs' words from Connecting the Dots. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinion drown you out your inner voice. And most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. Thank you, friends, and have a great evening. Thank you so much.
Hello, Aparna, ordinary guest of honor 9, ते आमची मुली आहे. Exactly 20 years back, 1999, तुम्ही असा बसलेले असा ते आली होती स्कॉलरशिप घ्यायला. आज गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर बनून स्टेजवरती बसलेली आहे. तुम्हाला बनायचं आहे ना गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर? दिस इज अ व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग दॅट शी इज डॉटर टू मॉम अँड डॅड. शी इज पार्ट ऑफ द फाउंडेशन फॉर लाईफ टाईम. इट्स नथिंग टू डू विथ स्कॉलरशिप. 4 वर्षाच्या स्कॉलरशिपचा प्रश्न नाही. ते नील आमची बरोबर आहे आणि आज स्टेजवरती आलेली आहे. एक टाईम तुमची जशी स्कॉलरशिप घ्यायला आली होती, टुडे शी सपोर्टिंग द फाउंडेशन. दिस इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. तुम्हाला बी शिक्षण घ्यायला पाहिजे की हाऊ टू गिव्ह अँड हाऊ टू टेक. देवानी दोन हात दिलेले आहेत, एक हाताने द्यायचं आणि एक हाताने घ्यायचं. दोन्ही हाताने घेणार तो काय होणार? पोट दुखणार. आता मी सायटेशन देते ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर बोर्ड ऑफ ट्रस्टीज, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ लीला पुनाला फाउंडेशन, इन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे आय रीड द सायटेशन. इट इज इन इंग्लिश बट आय नो यू अंडरस्टँड. LILA Punala Foundation, leading Indian ladies ahead. The mom's name is LILA, leading Indian ladies ahead. Mrs. Aparna Dharma, LILA Fellow 1999 and entrepreneur. It is a pleasure to have you in our midst as our chief guest. Sorry, guest of honor. You are a source of empowering the young LILA girls. We are very proud that you continue to be a part of LILA family. 30th November 2019, Board of Trustees.